The best way to measure how people learn a task or an interface is by running a learning experiment. In a learning experiment, people come into the lab and do the same task multiple times. Each time the person does the task, the experimenter records how long it takes them to do it. If the task times get faster, it means that people have learned from their previous experience, and the numbers show how much they've learned. The power law of learning says that the time it takes to perform a task decreases with the number of repetitions of that task. And the decrease follows a specific shape, a learning curve, which happens to be a special type of a power law. This is an example of a learning curve. Mathematically, it's described by the equation y equals a multiplied by x to the power of minus b, where a and b are constants. It turns out that for any type of task, anything from solving a Rubik's Cube to creating a new chart in Excel, if you were to plot the time it takes people to do it against how many times they've done it before, you'll obtain a curve like this. Let's look a little more closely at this curve. When you first start learning how to do a task, it takes a long time to do it. This is generally true for any task. By the second time, you'll be faster. By the third time, you'll be even faster, and so on. At a certain point, each additional repetition won't bring much improvement. You might still get a little bit faster, but not by much. When you reach this area of the curve, it means that most of the learning has been done. Let's now look at a redesign scenario. One big problem for application designers is that when a new version of their app is released, established users complain. So why do users dislike the new version so much? With the old interface, they may have already reached the area of the curve where their performance is pretty much stable. Because they've used the interface a lot in the past, they are already efficient at doing the task, and there is not much learning to be done. They are in the flatter area of the curve. But when you introduce a new interface, you send users back to repetition number one. Their efficiency is poor, and they have to spend time to learn the new interface when they could have used the old interface instead and accomplished the task a lot faster. It's a loss of productivity. So it's not just that change is hard and people don't like new things. They really are less productive and less efficient at first with a new interface or with a new design pattern. They need quite a few repetitions in order to learn it. Because of that, interface changes should be deployed slowly and purposefully. They should be incremental rather than major. Advocate for the value of the change and habituate users with the idea of change. And last but not least, let users toggle between old and new versions of your apps so they can avoid productivity losses.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these videos over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website ngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live hands-on UX training.